Well, hello everyone, I'm Yanni from BU4U Gaming, and today I'm gonna try out a new game. Well, the game itself is not new, but it's new to me. It's called Plague Incorporated Evolved, or Plague Inc. Evolved. And it's kind of a mix between strategy and simulation, where you play as a pathogen that has to take over the world. So you have, I think there's 10 different diseases you can choose from. So it's like bacteria and virus and you can even enslave people, make them into zombies, and yeah, there's even I think it's some kind of simian virus or something related to the Planet of the Apes movie, and I haven't actually checked up on it that much. I just saw this game on Steam a while back when it was on sale, and I picked it up and then I kind of forgot about it. It used to be a game for mobiles, actually. You can still play them on mobiles and tablet devices. You can even get some t-shirts and stuff, it looks like. And yeah, there's a board game too for the game. But I haven't watched any Let's Plays of this game, and I only tried playing through the tutorial once, and that's kind of it. So I think we're gonna give this a try. You can even create your own scenarios. I think there's a competition or something. I seem to recall seeing something on Steam about it. Who can make the best scenario or something. There's multiplayer, where you can either team up with someone else, so you have two different pathogens that team up and try to either eradicate or enslave the human population, or you can compete with each other, so who's gonna dominate the world? And I haven't tried that, of course, either. I'm just gonna go with the single player. So, yeah, there are some official scenarios. I think there is 20 different ones. I'm not sure how they work. And then there's the custom ones. I guess that's the one all the players can make and upload. There's even a speed one. Wow. And the one I played through was like the tutorial. Well, I managed to infect everyone and eradicate the human population. But based on that, the game seemed quite easy, and it was kind of over way too fast, but based on what it says on Steam, I would imagine that there's a lot more to the game than that. So yeah, just gonna go with the main game. And yeah, then you can choose what you want to play as. I haven't really unlocked anything. Well, I can play as the bacteria, which I think I'm gonna go with. That's the same I did in the tutorial, and then you can unlock all these like virus, fungus, Norax worm, parasite, prion, necrura virus. That sounds like something with vampires or something. I would think necrura, something with, yeah, nanovirus, bioweapons, then there's the simian flu and the shadow. Okay, this looks like the vampires. Then what is this one? I don't know. But yeah, I'm not gonna try these yet because looks really interesting, but I imagine they are pretty hard or something. So I think we're just gonna go with the bacteria for now. The way you unlock these seems to be as you manage to win the game. Maybe even in a certain way, then you unlock some of these. I don't know if you can unlock them in any other ways, but yeah. Apparently I unlocked 27%. Well, okay, there's 3 out of these, so... Okay, and I have like the 0 file. That's the one that I... and a gene that I unlocked during my tutorial. So that is the only one I have. I would be able to unlock other ones. You can see there's all kinds of options here. The zero file will give your plague a bonus in arid climates. Oh, okay, we're gonna pick that one. Genes unlocked 1%. So yeah, so that's probably about 100 genes to unlock. Continue. Game difficulty, yeah, I think we're gonna go with the casual one. The reason it normally would say normal and it wouldn't have picked the gene for you is because I just logged in to kind of check the sound and such. I may have to optimize that a little more, maybe turn up the sound a little bit. The in-game sound may be a little too low, but we'll see. But I think I'm gonna go with casual since I'm very new to the game, so no one washes their hands. Research doctors don't work, sick people given hugs. Okay, yeah. So this sounds more normal. 67.3% of people wash hands, doctors work 3 days a week. Well, in the real world they work more or less 7 days a week, I think. Sick people ignored. And compulsive hand washing. Doctors never go home, sick people locked in prison. Oh my. I wouldn't want to get sick in that environment, in that community. For strategic geniuses living in concrete bunkers. Ooh. And then there's the mega brutal, for players who thought brutal was casual. Yeah. Genetic drift impacts evolution. Doctors invest in research. Random medical checkups. Okay, well. We are just gonna go with the casual one. So, what are we gonna name our plague? I have no idea. I'm so terrible when it comes to naming stuff. So, Nubian. That's not really how we spell that. Nubian. Yeah. That's just gonna be the name of our little bacteria here. Okay, so welcome to Plague Incorporated. You are a new bacteria. To win, you must evolve and spread across the world, wiping out all humans in the ultimate plague. Okay, we'll have to see if we can do that. Yeah, we have to select a start location. Pop the start bottle, yeah. So, let's see. From the little I know from the tutorial, it's often best to choose one of the lesser developed countries because it will usually take longer before they notice that something is wrong. But also, I think it would probably be good idea to choose something that has an airport or a harbor to increase the chance to spread to another. Like if you choose a place up here, it will take a long time before we can get anywhere. Okay, we don't even get an airport in Denmark where I live, or in Sweden and Norway and Finland. In Scandinavia we don't have an airport at all. Okay, so yeah, up here would probably not be the best either, or over here. Oh yeah, because you don't have a great chance at spreading. Or maybe somewhere here. So let's see. I'm gonna take this rather as slow as I can actually. It runs, I feel like the time runs pretty fast once the game starts. But let's see. Well, if I go with India, then we have like both an airport and a harbor. We only have, well, we do have an airport and two harbors in Australia. Two harbors. Well, from here it would probably take a while too, even though they're sailing, but yeah. I think we're gonna go with India. So, here we go. Okay, so we got some information. Land borders open. Yeah, this is something you have to keep an eye on too, that if they start closing this before you manage to spread to other countries, then you'll have a problem. So, okay, then I can see. Warm country, humid country, and hot country. Okay, well, there we go. Nubian begins in India. Nubian has infected its first human, weak but used to hot temperatures. It must evolve using DNA points to infect more people. Yes, and the DNA points we can see down here, so we have to pop this one. That gave us one. enable. We can follow the news up here, we can speed up the time over here. And yeah, you can see the boats and the airplanes going around. We can see where it's slowly spreading. Nubian begins to spread. Nubian is spreading from person to person in India and will grow exponentially. You control the plague indirectly by evolving it. Yeah. So we're gonna pop this one too. That gave us some more of these points. So let's see if I can remember. Okay, Q. If you hit Q, then you get this overview. So this is our bacteria. It's 0 farm. Give a plague a bonus in arid climates. Okay, so that's probably gonna show us all the stuff that we, when we get more genes, hopefully. Start date. Plague type bacteria. Yeah, it's kind of interesting. So that's on the date that you start the game. So, genetic complexity is simple. Yeah, we only have one gene. Daily infections, 3. Average infections, 1. Start location, India. Difficulty, casual. DNA use, 0. Yeah, we haven't done any upgrades yet. Daily deaths, average deaths, all 0. So we have 10 DNA points. Our infectivity is low. Severity, very low. We're not really killing anyone at all. Lethality over here, we haven't killed anyone. Well, our infectivity has gone up a little bit, but now it's kind of flattened out. And we haven't done anything about severity and lethality. What does this do? Graft. Ooh. Oh, okay, cool. I didn't even know there was one of these. Cure requirement. Can we do anything? Oops. Huh. Okay, so if I then I okay, so cure requirement is pretty high, research conducted 0, yeah, okay. And yeah, infectivity really evolved yet. And population 100% healthy, we only have a few infected and no one has died yet. Ah, okay. That is interesting. Overview, evolution history, yeah, we haven't done anything. Transmission. Alright, here we can choose to evolve. So. Maxi, did I? Okay, so we can choose, okay, we can choose this one. No, we don't have enough, we need 12 DNA points, but we can evolve, well, we click here. Gives pathogen abilities to travel and dust particles increase infectivity, especially in arid environments and plane transmission. That would probably be pretty nice, then there's sheep and mouse and birds, insects. This is, yeah, blood spot contact and true water, fresh warm water. Then we can change the symptoms to warm new symptoms. Irritated stomach lining leads to discomfort, slight chance of infection when kissing. Yeah, so you get symptoms, which is, of course, I would say would help the humans figuring out which disease it is. But of course, if you have quite a lot of the symptoms, then it's really confusing to figure it out. Because then it can be all kinds of stuff. But at the same time, like you see, it also increases our chance of infecting someone. Chance of infection by spreading pathogen into surroundings, especially in high density urban areas. Yeah, that's coughing. And we have a rash. Becomes blistered and painful. Inability to sleep makes people irritable and less productive. Cysts. Painful lumps containing pockets of the pathogen. Slight chance of bursting, which can spread disease. Anemia. Decrease in red blood cells or hemoglobin in the blood can lead to hypoxia in the organs. Okay. And then we have some abilities. pathogen evolves to withstand cold temperatures and climates. Well, at the moment we are in a hot climate in India. Well, it's mostly hot. I know in northern India it can be a little bit cold and no in their winter time, in the night time, but not like here in Denmark anyway. Not that I have experienced anyway when I was in India. Bacterial resilience. Create bacterial shell to protect against all climates. So that's kind of a general defense. That's pretty good actually. Pathogen evolves to withstand hot temperatures and climates. Well, we are already a little bit good at this, I think. And there's this one. Pathogen becomes resistant to class 1 and 2 antibiotics. Increase effectiveness in wealthy countries. Yeah, this is one we're definitely gonna go for a little later when we start spreading. So what are we gonna start with? I have no idea what's best. In the tutorial I was kind of just panic clicking. And I actually managed to get around most of it. But it just seemed a little easy, and I'm pretty sure it's not as easy in now that we are playing the actual game. And I haven't really figured out. I have a feeling that you can, well, if you evolve this way, then from here you can go somewhere else. So I have a feeling that you can kind of spread out and choose to focus on one thing, or you can kind of do all of them, but you can also end up blocking off some of it if you spread a lot. But it seems like I didn't get that far in the tutorial, even though I got a lot of them, but not really far enough to block some of them from evolving further. So what do we want? Symptoms maybe. Let's see, rash, coughing, nausea, insomnia, cysts, anemia, high density urban areas. Well, there is quite a lot of people in India, but it's not all high density. It is in New Delhi and places like that, of course. Transmission. Well, there's insects, water, air maybe, dust particles. Well, that's not really aerated. This is really hard to decide what to go with now. So, well, we do have insects in India too, so no, I don't think we're gonna go with this one. Airborne. So, now we only have 40. Well, maybe we can actually. Because these don't take that much, do they? So if we go for coughing. Yeah, 4 DNA, so we're gonna go with some coughing too. There we go, now we don't have any more DNA points. Not sure what this does. Oh, some DNA points to evolve new symptoms for your plague. Do we do anything down here? No, not really. Interesting. Okay. Well, what is this? World screen. Oh, okay. Yeah, I think this is the one you get up when you hit E when you are out in a game. So just take a little look at this before we keep going. Yeah, so this is all our health. You can see all the countries we need to infect. We have one infected country, which is India. And we have some dead countries. I don't know if this is when they are completely. Yeah, when 0% is alive, then they start dying. So, what can we do up here? Okay, that's probably temperature. Toggle cold countries. Toggle hot countries. Toggle arid countries. Well, we have that arid gene, like 0 final. So, if we can spread that way, that would be really nice. Okay, so arid is something like, I don't really know what that means. It's kind of a little desert-like, I guess. Might be. Looks like this is, yeah, like Arabian countries or something, so, and then Australia and Southern Africa and such, so that might be a little bit like that. But this one, that's humid countries. Okay. Four countries. Okay, so India is, well, yeah, they do have, there's a lot of money, it's just not really the people that have all that money. So I wouldn't consider it a rich country, but yeah, I guess it is. Talking rich. Okay, so it is in between, so we have like the poor, the rich, and then the poor. Oh, we are a rich country, I can see. Yeah. Rural countries. Well, that's this one, and most of Russia, Middle Africa, and South America. Okay. And bear with me, my geography is, that's not my favorite topic. Top urban countries. Okay, so China, Scandinavia, Great Britain, most of Europe, Italy, what's that? Oh, Libya. Alright, I can see the names when I actually mouse over them. So, in Australia and the US, of course. Yeah. Okay. Not quite sure yet what that's gonna help, apart from rich and poor and humid and all that. Nubian has not been noticed. No, there's only a few infected, almost 100% healthy out of our little over 7 billion people. 22 infected, yeah, that's not many. Status no research because they haven't noticed it yet. Key research contributors. I'm not quite sure how you can do anything against this or like control where you spread, because they say you can kind of counteract. Well, it sounds like when you read the description for the pain that for the game, that you can kind of counteract what the humans are doing, but I didn't really get a feeling for that in the tutorial. But maybe I missed something, because they did start research and I was like, okay, well, sure. And then what? I wasn't quite, and you can see who's the key research contributors, and in that, my case in the tutorial, it was Australia that was kind of sending out airplanes to collaborate with other countries, and I was like, okay, but what can I do about that, you know? So yeah, but I hope I'll figure that out. Alright, destroyed research labs, active research labs, inactive. Yeah, at some point you'll get some blue bubbles that will pop up, and then you can, if you click them, that kind of destroys some of their research. Total open borders, total open ports, total open airports. Yeah, they haven't noticed me yet. So, global priority level, I guess that's based on how dangerous they think the pathogen is. What does this do? Graph screen? Oh, okay, cool. Okay, well, that was kind of just a little overview, because I haven't really looked that much at it, apart from... Okay, so you can switch between them there, okay. So, here we go. You have successfully evolved Nubian. You have spent DNA points to evolve your disease, and more options have opened up. Get more points by popping DNA and biohazard bubbles and infecting people. Yeah, I think maybe you can turn these messages off in the settings. I seem to recall there was some option to turn something off. At the moment I think this is cool, but maybe when you are experienced with the game, then you don't really care about these. So let's see. Think what would happen in real life. While Plague Incorporated is a hyper-realistic model of the world, plan your strategy and evolve your disease accordingly by spending DNA points. Yeah. Well, we only have 1 point so far, so... And yeah, I could speed up time, but just trying to figure this out. Pop orange DNA bubbles when they randomly appear to get bonus DNA points, which you can use to evolve your disease. Okay. Now we have 6 points, so we could probably do some more. We're gonna spread to a different country soon. We haven't made it to the airport yet. find out more about a country, click the country name at the bottom of the screen to open the country menu. That's the world. Oh. Nubian has infected hundreds in India, increasing the chance that an infected person will infect a healthy person. Keep evolving your disease. Yeah, I know. Okay, like that, and then we can click. Okay. Business as usual. Yeah, I haven't noticed it yet. Wow, almost 1.5 billion. That's quite a big percentage of the world population, actually. When we have 7 billion in the world, so yeah. So hoping it will spread. We're getting close to the border right there. New Delhi, that's around here somewhere, isn't it? I don't know. So what is this? Scanning? Okay. So what can it do? It can't do anything, we can just see a picture. Okay. Medical research, they haven't done anything. Well, 309 infected. Government. Yeah, but I still really don't know exactly what to do with this. So, I guess we should do something here. So, see, now you can move on, so we can go to sneezing. Fluid discharge through sneezing greatly increases infection rates. Or serious fluid build and discharge from the lungs. People in cold climates, especially vulnerable. Well, we're not really in a cold climate at the moment. At the moment, and that's pneumonia. So now we should go for some transmission. Let's see. Yeah. Well, it's not an arid country, actually. If it's a humid country, right? Ship transmission. I'm gonna pick that one. Let's see. Okay. So, if you have any tips for something I clearly don't know, or something I should notice on those information screens, then be sure to let me know. Like, I can see this, but it doesn't really seem to show me much. Was this marked before? I guess this is supposed to signify something, these out here. I'm not sure. I can't really do anything. So if you know anything about what that screen is supposed to do with the skeleton here, then let me know. Here's the overview. Can we see anything in this yet? No, we still only have that one gene. Okay, how infectious? Well, that's going up at least. Average infection 73, evolution history. Okay, transmission, symptoms, abilities. Well, we haven't really spread yet, so don't think we really need that one. Cold. Is that hot temperatures and climates? Symptoms. Rash, anemia, hypoxia. That might be a good one. I'm also kind of thinking, what would people... Well, coughing is not something I usually, but that's probably because in Denmark it's very often that people have a cold or, you know, have the flu or something, so it's not something that we usually think, oh no, someone is, you know, really sick just because they're coughing. But if you get a rash, for instance, that might make people go to the doctor. Nausea is not also not something I would usually pay that much attention to. Insomnia, that could just be because you're stressed or something. Cysts, that would also make people go to a doctor, I'm thinking. And this decrease in red blood cells, that's not something you would notice right away, I don't think. Maybe we'll pick that one. I don't know if it's even relevant in this game, but I'm just thinking that some of it is something that would make people pay attention. Maybe we should spread to the air. There we go. We haven't really left the country yet. Nubian has infected thousands, being infected faster and faster. Okay. Well, it is a big country and there's quite a lot of people, but I'm kind of surprised that we haven't left the country yet. Okay. 40,000. China has been infected. Your disease has taken an important step in becoming a plague. When a new country is infected, pop the red bottle to get... Bubble to get bonus DNA. Okay, can you take screenshots in this game? Apart from the Steam ones? Doesn't seem like it. Okay. There we go. If we pause this for a second, there's also the news up here. Let's see. Nubian begins in India. Nurse wages soared due to global shortage. Billions of pre-orders for latest smartphones. Yeah, media file sharing website banned. Ooh. Stem cell treatments for all. A decade away, says WHO. Lemur fur toilet paper inhumane. China trade deficit narrows. I'm also not quite... Well, none of this seems to be relevant for us just yet, but there will be some pop-ups that's about people getting sick and such eventually when they start noticing. Oh, we're spreading out here now. So, Morocco. Oh, and I could actually hear someone coughing. I think I have to turn up the in-game sound a little bit, because I don't think you can maybe hear it. Can we zoom in even more than that? I have no idea. Egypt. Okay, that's another big country. 82 million? Wow. Like, for comparison, we are like, I don't know how many we are now, 6 or 7 million in Denmark? Okay, so, well, it's kind of cool with these pictures, but it doesn't really tell me much of anything it's scanning, but yeah. And what are you telling me? It's a poor country? Arid country, that's good, because that's the country we can spread in. And a hot country. Yeah. Still nothing is closed and no one has noticed us yet, so... Okay. More countries control where it goes by evolving transmission traits in the disease menu. Yeah, okay. Well, that's these, and that was what I was doing. Like, we can spread through the water and through the air. I do have some hot countries, so maybe some insects might be a good idea. In hot climates, yeah. Chance of mutation, that was pretty cool actually. Mutations is always good when it comes to this, because then it's harder to find a cure for the pathogen when it mutates. So that is not bad at all. Okay. More infectious than tuberculosis. Nubian has infected more people in the world than TB. It is a very infectious disease. Okay, so are people beginning to notice us? Oh, look at that. Now it's going fast. Wow. Oh, we're spreading down here. More infectious than HIV. It is an extremely... Yeah, okay. Well, let's see. Abilities. What do we need for this one? Drug resistance, we need 12. Because I think I would like that one, so just need a little bit more. Oh, look at that. I need to zoom out actually. So now we're spreading to the US. Medicine in USA is slowing infection. USA is the wealthy country with high quality healthcare. To spread faster, you may need to hope. That's exactly what I wanted to do, so that is perfect. What's this one? Drug resistance becomes resistant to class 1 and class 2. So, that's what we're gonna do. What do we need for the next one? Okay, pathogen becomes harder to analyze in the lab. Well, they haven't really started researching yet, so I was more thinking about this one. Then you can develop resistance to class 3 and 4 antibiotics. Who needs 27? Yeah. Well, nothing cold. What else? Insomnia. Evolve. And you take a stomach, slight chance of infection when kissing. Okay. I'm gonna go for that, and we have 40 any points. Anything else we can do with that? Looks like we need more. Okay. Okay, so what does this time say here? We're almost out of time for this episode. New minor disease spreading in a normal checkup. A doctor in India found a new disease which has been named Nubian. It appears to be mostly harmless but must be investigated further. Other countries are also reporting this disease. Okay. Well, I think this is kind of it for this episode. This is interesting. It does seem to go a little bit slower than in the tutorial. So I'll see. And if you're playing the game yourself, then let me know if you have any tips to anything I should be doing that I'm not doing, or yeah, if I'm choosing my spending my DNA points in a bad way, or I should do it in a different order, or yeah, just let me know. Leave some comments. So. And I hope there wasn't too much noise in the end of the episode, because apparently my neighbor decided to start drilling, probably putting something up on the wall or something. So I think it's a good time to end this episode. So thank you for watching, and please leave a like or a comment, and take care everyone.